Okay, so I'll tell you this for a fact. A number of my friends like to say you're smug. You don't even want to have an intellectual conversation. You just want to like mock and talk down religion because you don't have the balls to actually intellectually engage and have an adult and mature conversation. It's easier to say when you haven't really taken time to look at my content, to visit my Substack and read how many things I put up there and how many articles I've written about religion, as well as the nature with which I approached those writings. I mean, if you look at any of those things, it speaks for itself. I'm in no business of mockery and cheap talk and low-hanging fruit type conversations as well as debates. I admit the God conversation is a very like loaded conversation, and I'm not poised to even be like the person that actually debates the God question. It's just that the God question is a question that involves all of us as humans. Each one of us, we reach a point where we have to grapple with the fact that we need to make sense of like God's existence. Questions about God are questions that involve all of us. Of course, there are people who are better poised to have these debates, these conversations, granted. I don't think I have the intellectual capacity or the philosophical muscle to engage this conversation deeply in any meaningful sense. But as an average everyday dude, I feel like this question involves each one of us. You need to reach a point in your life where you seriously ask yourself where you stand with regards to this question. So when I get heat up with these allegations that I'm just in the game of like, you know, trash talking religion, and it seems like I'm just like born out of this gingered up new atheist movement, and I'm not in any position to actually engage on a serious level. That's a lie. Granted, look, we share stupid memes on WhatsApp statuses, mocking religion. No, Jesus' sacrifice was, he simply sacrificed his weekend. Like, we do all this stuff, like, on our statuses. But if you really wanted to know how I engage with the God question, you gotta visit my Substack, man. Read some of the shit I've published already. Look at the content I've published already. Look at the videos that I've made on my channel. Instead of, like, you know, trivializing everything because you saw me share a meme on my ex or on my status or on my Facebook. Like, we are not who we are 90% of the time on social media. And this is true because there are people who've actually come to my inbox trying to have this conversation with me. I remember two people that just like ghosted me afterwards. You know, on Facebook, they were really sounding so smug. They would approach me with all this air of like intellectual hubris, as if I was up to no good or I was up to something crazy. Then I told them, if you're really serious about having this conversation with me, like, come to my inbox, man. Here's my line. Text me on WhatsApp. We can use voice notes. We can have an actual constructive conversation. Some of them would laugh it off just because they wanted to have this conversation in a space where we're just like trash talking each other and mocking each other in the comment section without any substantial conclusion whatsoever. So I've had a fair share of such conversation, and I was in no position to just entertain everybody who just like wants to argue in the comment section without practically getting anywhere. So most people, these two people that I actually told, like, look, come and have a conversation with me, they did. We had an actual real conversation. We exchanged book recommendations. But one pattern I noticed is once this conversation starts to happen, it never fully like finishes. You know what I mean? These people just like go quiet, or they just get tired. They tire out of it. They just go like, you know what? Okay, I'll respond to this guy maybe sometime later. Then in no time you find yourselves practically talking about other things away from the God question. So no, I don't do low-hanging fruit type conversations. If you want to know my perspectives on religion, my Substack would tell you everything. And I've got an old WordPress account. It practically tracks down my intellectual journey. I have articles I used to write as a goofy Jehovah's Witness. Articles that are like really intellectually embarrassing to even read today. Like I look at some of his stuff, I'm like, fuck. What was I thinking, man? But here we are. Like, And I have not really taken this stuff that I could have actually like taken down the whole WordPress account just so I could look like intellectually consistent and, you know, like cool. But all these things are still there. Like you could practically see my intellectual journey because I detailed everything. You could see how I used to think in this place, and you could see how I gradually changed my perspective on practically everything. It's like I did a whole 360 on religion. Like it's all there, documented. And so it strikes me as like slightly disrespectful to approach me and say like, you are in a position where you just want to mock, trash talk, and not have an actual constructive conversation about the God question. Like, come on, bro. Do you even know me? Do you even know me? Yeah. So I think in closing, one thing I can say is nothing has changed. I'm an atheist, and I've been an atheist for close to like 5 years now. I haven't changed my position on God, and I feel like the God question has slightly become irrelevant in my life. I had a video where I was talking about how belief in God has practically become like not an immediate concern to me. Like I don't see the need for it. I don't see what it is that I'm gaining or losing. Yeah, it's become almost painfully insignificant. Like I'm just a normal person. I just go about my life with ease and peace of mind. For my ordeals and where I turn to, 90% of the time people tend to ask me like, where do you turn to? Where do you go in times of like calamity and ordeal? Who do you talk to? Who do you turn to? I turn to nobody. I talk to myself. I find strength and power within. I don't pray to anybody. I feel like if I'm going through like really, really seriously depressing times, I almost like float through the wave of the calamity I'm in. Like I just go with the time because routine and the passage of time has actually shown me that all these things ease down with the passing of time. Like I don't consciously feel like I emotionally need an outstretched hand from the celestial beyond. Yeah, but it's just, what I'm trying to say is the whole question has become almost so commonplace that I just don't see the need or the value. I don't have like very well-versed philosophical arguments for my disbelief, but I just don't see the need for it. And one way I come down on this question is purely like scientific because of my background. I used to be a Jehovah's Witness by faith. And I was practically a biblical fundamentalist. I believed what the Bible says, and I took stories like Noah's Ark as historical facts, Adam and Eve as our first historical human beings. Everything for me was like material and actual historical evidence for the human experience and everything that we see around us. That's how deep it was. There was no Big Bang, there was no evolution by natural selection or evolution by anything. It was just simply the creative hand of Jehovah. And so when I started to understand like simple mainstream science, nothing complicated, and just how it practically makes biblical fundamentalism almost hard to reconcile with like actual mainstream science, that created a huge problem for me that actually isn't a problem for some Christians now, because hypothetically, I can think of myself as a Christian with little to no concern for the problems I had coming out of my religion as a Jehovah's Witness. I can do that. Today, I can like, you know, develop an interest to extensively read on theistic arguments. I already watched like really good thinkers like Trent Horn, Josh Rasmussen, Capturing Christianity. These are guys I admire and guys I don't even have the balls to argue against. But I just, it feels, the mere fact that belief in God almost feels preferential just creates this thing in my head that just trivializes the whole enterprise. I don't know if I'm making any sense, but yeah, I just don't see the need for it. You know what I mean? Yeah. And what I argue against most 90% of the time when we're talking about religion is biblical fundamentalism. Yeah. Not these philosophically nuanced arguments for the existence of God. There's a lot of brain power to burn and a lot of reading to do. So yeah, that's just what I do. If you go to my Substack, you find me biting at concepts like Noah's Ark and crazy, creepy Bible verses. Obviously, things that are like obviously intuitively just like wrong, you know? So yeah, I don't trivialize the God question. Neither do I engage in it in a childish, smug way. And this is obvious if only you could just look at my stuff. Until next time, I love you, man. Keep praying to Jesus. Jesus is Lord.